hopefully it'll work. I don't know if it's loud enough, council, it's not as loud as it could be, so when you are speaking, coaches, please make sure you speak right to the front of the microphone, that'll help. I would like to welcome everyone to the second session for 2009-2010 Winter Sports Recognition Night. I attended games in every sport at every level, and I was impressed with our student athletes. I saw a lot of good sportsmanship, individual skills improvement, and unselfish team play. Our coaches put in a great deal of time and their effort with their athletes, and I'd like to take a moment to thank all of them. I'd like to thank these and our for typing the certificates and the program, and our custodial and maintenance staff for all their help during the season. I'd also like to thank the members of our Houston Booster Club for their support and every parent that worked in the concession stand. Overall, three of our seven varsity teams won CBAC championships this winter, and several others were in the hunt, a great accomplishment for our school district. In this session, we will recognize the students who participated in basketball and cheerleading. Our boys varsity basketball team won the Bobcat Shootout Championship and were ranked honorable mention in the state, and they also received the Officials Sportsmanship Award. The varsity cheerleading team won the CBAC championship, a somewhat bittersweet accomplishment this season after the tragic accident and loss of one of our cheerleaders. The girls' varsity basketball team had a coaching change this year, but continued their winning tradition with another CBAC championship, and were ranked sixth in the state at that time. And our girls' team also had the most valuable player in the league this year. Congratulations to all of our athletes on their accomplishments this season. No matter how small or how big, we are proud of all of you. In addition to their athletic talents, 56 student athletes earned high honors in academics while participating on a winter team. And four of our varsity teams qualified for the New York State Public High School Athletic Association Scholar Athlete Team Award. On behalf of the coaching staff, I wish the best for our seniors who have played in their last winter sport here at Northeastern Club. I would ask that everyone shows respect for the coaches by not talking while they're commenting on individual and team accomplishments. And when I calm the team down, would you please hold your applause until the end of the player introductions? Would you please have the boys modify a basketball team? Jason Abbott, Jonathan Casoli, Callan Dussel, John Fillion, Austin Corky, Matthew Lefay, Zach Lucas, Wyatt Rivers, Harley Tavernier, Brendan Boutet, Jacob Brown, Nick Dragoon, Chase Sample, Theo Sisson, Austin Taker, Manager Eric Scutler, and Manager General Bell. Good coordination from our physical education instructor here. Please welcome the boys from the NCCS basketball team.
Good evening. I'd like to start off as always by thanking Mrs. Gilroy for making this season and all the seasons possible. Obviously, it'd be a lot tougher without her here, and once again, I'd just like to thank her for all the hard work she does for us. I'd also like to thank Coach Davidson and Coach Guerin, who are always a pleasure to work with. They make working with each and every level just a great time. We can look forward to coming back and work with these guys every year. Also, of course, my managers, Jenna and Eric, make the practices run so smoothly, and all the help we need Thanks a lot, guys, for helping us out. Overall, we had a pretty good team come together this year. We had a lot of returners, which is a great thing, and at a modified level, you don't usually get the chance to see your players come back. It only happened for a couple years, and several returners came back this year, making for a great season. Then we did start out slow. We started out about 1-3, but we gained some confidence and figured out what we could do throughout the year. We finished up nicely with an overall record of 9-5, which was impressive. These guys worked hard to get there. If I have it back next year, I'd certainly do that. That's good. Okay, we'll be back next year. I do have two awards I'd like to give out this year, and the first one goes to a player who made great strides, not only this year, but last year, who's really become a confident player, and whose defense is about as reliable as I could ask from anybody on my team. This player stayed with us last year as a manager, worked hard, came back and earned a spot on the team this year, and actually became a starter by the end of this season. So this year's most improved player goes to Austin Ford. My second award goes to a player who was willing to give it all on and off the court at practice or in games. I could pretty much draw up any play, and he performed it for us to the best of his ability. I can always count on this player to get the job done, no matter how big or small. And I know he's going to continue to do great things for our basketball program. My MVP this year goes to Harley Tatum. Pleasure working with you for the past 2 years. If you continue on with our program, which I know many of you will, I wish you luck in the years to come and all that you will do. And to our entire team, my first year players, hopefully you'll be back with me next year. I look forward to work with you guys as well. And thank you very much.
Thank you.
Sarah Batty. Jennifer Bernard. Abby Miller. Christina Paola. Taylor Rabbit. Shauna Barkley. Danielle Kelson. Tiana Ledoux. Kelly Sample. Michaela Snyder. Rachel Sylvester. Austin Roger, the manager.
Austin.
Yeah, Austin!
This is my manager. This boy's been with me since school started. I'll tell you what, I gotta give him credit. He's a good one.
We do have the girls' modified basketball team and coach for the Cougars.
Thank all the parents that worked the booth.
booster club since the beginning of the year. It's a big part of this program. It's something that everybody's got to think about down the road, because we're going to be losing some good people, but there's a lot of good people to fill those spots. And we've got good kids here, we've got good athletes, and we need that parent support. So a couple hours working out there and stuff, it really pays off. I'd like to thank Norm Bonham. Not only did these young ladies have to go some rigorous practices, but I brought Norm in the gym. He put several hours in there. And between the two of us, it was a lot of fun. One group at one end, one group at the other, and vice versa, and things went real well. So anybody sees Norm, just, you know, put a little plug in and hey, thanks for still up on our program. Because he's a big part of this community, and he's helped a lot of young athletes over the years. I'd like to thank first year JV coach Erin. She came into the gym, scrimmaged a little bit, was there when Norm was there. Of course, I can hardly walk anymore, but I really get up and down the court with my eyes. And for her first year, she was right into the title hunt right to the end. And my hat's off to her. She did a good job at that JV level. And of course, our new varsity coach, Dave Lindbergh, he's number one in my book. This guy cares about the whole program. He's very concerned from fifth grade all the way up through. He knows his program. And he did a real good job keeping everybody happy. And our future's in pretty good hands with coaches like that. And congratulations to my team. I'm going 11-3 in the CBAC. A couple of losses to Saranac. It was a real good program. And we hung around with them a little bit. And our other loss was to El Sable. They had a real nice club. But on a given night, that game could have went either way. But you girls had a heck of a season. You worked hard. And you deserve all the credit you get. Now for my awards. My first most improved player goes to Callie Sample. My second most improved player, speed, unbelievable. Really picked up her game at the end. Again, Norm and I work a lot on going to the basket, taking your girl to the basket. And this girl picked it up real well. My second most improved player goes to Taylor Rappin. Two most valuable players, good team leaders, good students. Again, the whole team were good students. I think I had at least 7 or 8 high honors. That's pretty darn good. The two most valuable players are my team captains. They were good leaders. First ones most of the time in practice, last ones to leave, and are an asset to this school. Goes to Christina Paola and Abby Miller. Thank you very much. Austin, cool buddy, would you come up here and get a little something? And by the way, I need a couple dozen eggs. I'll set a little business on the side, so not only am I going to get a little advertisement here in this auditorium, it's going to be on television. This young guy right here, he's a farmer. He's a chicken farmer. He raises chickens. Sells some of the finest fresh eggs in the area. Then, if your phone rings off of the hook and you get all sorts of emails, remember me when you're famous, okay? Thank you.
We went 11-3. The first few games went great until we hit Saranac, but we got back up and won the next few after that. We had a bad habit of lowering our standards for the other teams, and for that, we had to run the whole practice. We learned a lot, like don't give up in the middle of the game, forget to get our passes accurate. We also had some pretty fun times, like when Austin called his little friends in the wall. Probably the robot, it's one of his favorite. Never had him. All the quotes coaches gave us about sports and life. He gave me a couple quotes about life. I enjoyed it. Thanks for your grace.
As a team, we'd like to thank Ms. Gilroy for scheduling games, Mr. Vama for coordinating practices and games, and for helping us work on getting better moves. Also, for being a manager that can manage and entertain at the same time. All the parents that brought their kids and supported us. And last but not least, Mr. Dewey for being a great coach that taught us so much.
Their game because they worked hard. They listened and they tried to carry out the game plan.
We used various defenses and offenses and tried to mix it up any way we could to keep the other team off balance. And for the most part, it didn't work. Well, once in a while it did, but we just sustained the attack on offense and found ourselves always trying to catch up. Finishing was the biggest problem, followed by turnovers. Boy, did we have a lot of discussion about turnovers. But we handled it well. We had a great attitude. We had to come up with different goals and make the challenges a little bit smaller to try to progress, but I think we accomplished it. We reached our goals in practice and had to increase some, so that's always good. I was very proud of how hard they worked day in and day out. We had 4 eighth graders on our team, Brent Stein, Adam Cater, Rodney Grimshaw, and Garrett Gore. And I can't remember ever having that many on one of our JV teams. But these guys had a lot of growing up to do, and sometimes we handled it pretty well, and sometimes not. But that is expected with younger players. We discussed the pros and cons with the guys at the beginning of the season and told them I couldn't guarantee them any playing time, and we'd have to see how it went. But they would gain valuable experience, and at this level, and as eighth graders, they had a couple years left to go. So this year would be a breaking in year for them, and maybe give them the confidence and hopefully show them how much hard work they would need to put in to compete at this level. As it turned out, 2 of them ended up starting, and the 3rd one was the first one off the bench for most of the season. We had 2 ninth graders, Colton Provost, who worked very hard day in and day out and didn't get a lot of playing time, but he got in just about every game. And Kevin Sousa, who at first had to find his way and gradually found himself as getting more and more playing time as the season went on. He improved a lot. He improved a lot this year. Our sophomores, who played steady all year, Dalton Castine, Mike Manor, Alex Davidson, and Larry Girl. Dalton held his own out there and has the best shot on our team, and has an excellent attitude and knows what he can and can't do. He is quite the character and helps lighten up the practice with his array of comments and jokes and just being dumb, as I would tell him. I will miss his humor next year. Alex Davidson isn't here. He was my most improved player. His intensity, he works harder than anybody. His intensity is in practice, kind of rolls over to the other teammates, and I select him as the most improved player because of that, and because he improved immensely. Michael Manor. Mike and I had a lot of confrontations during the year. With the struggling offense and the collapses we had on defense sometimes, I expected the big Mike to take care of everything in the middle. And probably expected more than I should have, but if we were going to have any success, it would be directly related to how we could get him involved and how hard he was going to work, but also how long he could keep that intensity up throughout the whole game. The first thing I was impressed of was when he showed up to practice the first day was he got a haircut. If you see Mike last year, he had some hair. And he was much better without all that hair. But without him in the middle, we struggled. And he would get double teamed, and with our presence in the middle on defense, when he wasn't in there, we didn't fare very well. The improvements he has made from last year to this year has been tremendous. And as only a second player in our program, it looks like he has the heart and passion to be a good player. And if he works hard, he can be a big contributor on varsity next year. That's why I'm selecting him to receive the most valuable player award. Managers, Dylan Porter. Was a big help to our team and enjoyed being around the team. And enjoyed being in the locker room and both in practice. Jamie and Varsity had practice at the same time. I would have Katie come help with the Varsity practice and have Dylan say, hey, help me. Dylan filled in nicely and I think he had fun with it. And I hope he'll come back and help us out again next year. Dylan, come on.
Blair. Taylor Waddle. Kayla Dragon. Emily LaPorte. Courtney Ravenny. Allie Carter. Jordan Donner. Jennifer Farrell. Skylar Bieber. Miranda Menard. Morgan Ravenny. Please welcome the girls JV basketball team and coach Sharon Clark.
Good evening, everyone. I'd like to start off with a few thank yous as well. I'd like to thank Mrs. Gilroy for all her support throughout the season. I would also like to thank the varsity coach Dave Lambert and modified coach Frank Dumas for all of their support throughout the season, being my first season as a head coach here at NCCS. I would also like to thank Mr. Bono, who also came in and helped Myra out a few practices. He worked with my post players, since we obviously have a lot more experience with post players than I do as a guard. And last but not least, I'd like to thank Dale Bernard for keeping my book all season. That was very, very helpful for my team. So, the season. As I mentioned, this was my first season as a head coach, so coming into it, I had been told by a couple of people that I might be lucky if I went, you know, 500 with this team. So, me being me, I set the bar high and had very high expectations for these girls. The first day of practice, after evaluating them, I realized that some of them were behind in some skills and that we had a lot of work to do. So I really pushed them. Probably the first 3 to 4 weeks, we focused simply on fundamentals, dribbling, passing, shooting, defense, and I pretty much ran them like dogs and got them into some good shape. Our first game was a non-league game against Malone, which happens to be my alma mater. We did lose that game, but that was just a stepping stone for how we would do for the rest of the season. We ended up finishing the season overall 14-3. Our league and our conference, our final was 13-2. So I was extremely happy with how we performed throughout the season. But most important was the improvement that these girls showed. They looked like a completely different team from the first game to the last game of the season. And that was my ultimate goal, was for these girls all to improve. Not only as a team, but individually, and I feel that every individual player just had tremendous improvement. I couldn't have asked for a greater group of girls to start my career as a basketball coach here at NCCS. Being a school counselor, I know how girls can be. The drama, the cadence, the clicks. And these girls, I had none of that. None whatsoever. Everyone got along. We didn't have the drama, so I don't know how I got so lucky, but great group of girls. They came to practice every day, so eager to learn, so ready to play hard, and just improve and do the best that they could do. So I thank you, girls. You made my season very enjoyable, and I'm very proud of all of your accomplishments. I have two awards to give tonight. And the first award is the most improved player. This player was definitely one of my leaders from day one of the season. She brought so much positive energy and so much light to the team. She made practice fun every day. Her skills improved tremendously throughout the season. By the end of the season, she was helping run the point guard position for me. She started off the season not so much a fan of defense, playing defense. But that's my focus, is defense. So by the end of the season, she was saying she loved playing defense, and she was really, really improved. Her confidence really came around, and she just was very excited and just showed so much improvement. I can't wait to see what she contributes on the varsity level next year. And most improved player this year goes to Katie Blair. And my other award is for most valuable player. This player was one of my captains. She was a leader both on and off the court for me. She did everything that I could have possibly needed her to do as a player. She's a post player, but in her play games, I could count on her to help handle the ball, to help bring the ball up against pressure. She usually guarded the other team's best post player. She managed to still have strong offensive games, and normally when you're playing, you know, so hard on defense, it kind of takes you out of your offensive game a little bit, but not for her. She led the team in points this year, and she's just a great all-around player, and I'm excited to see her contribute as well next year at varsity level. This year's MVP is Kayla Dragon.
Jenna McMillan, Billy Bettelheimer. Joseph Gaines. Heather Dooley. Caitlin Short. Chelsea Bloom. Katrina Bordeaux. Caitlin Brothers. Serena Foster. Kelsey Delonte. Chelsea Vanderbilt. Amanda Harvey. Caitlin Blanchard. Amber Wallace. As I'm sure most of you know, Sarah Hunter started the season, but completed the first half and then due to a change in her work status, she had to give up the position and step out to Cougars. So please welcome the cheerleading team and coaches step out and Sarah.
Every year, we start out the school year with the newest attitude of the children's season will bring. This year, many of us seniors want to cherish the good times the season will hopefully bring. Well, over half our teens are young girls that have never cheered before, leading this year is going to be even harder for you all.
We faced our first problem toward the beginning of the season when our coach told us she had to stop coaching due to a job offering she needed to accept. As tears rolled down many of our faces, she told us, "Please remember, it's not me who makes you number one." Knowing she was right, we were forced with the thought of, "What now?" Luckily, we had Seth to fill the empty spot that needed to be replaced.
Our season was full of a lot of laughs and tears, but no matter how many times we all said we didn't want to be there, none of us gave up. Going into the competition, we didn't know what to expect, hearing that two teams had dropped out, we were unaware of what we were going up against. We practiced hard and came through with the win despite the obstacles we faced, including again a few being during competition.
We never thought that something so tragic would happen to my world. We never thought that the last time we said I love you, Morgan, would actually be the last time ever. When we got the news that Morgan would be with us for the remainder of the season, we all looked at each other and questioned whether we could go on with the season. We knew we had to. That's when Morgan was born. We dedicated our team to Morgan this year, which pushed us hard to win. You ladies have made our senior year one we'll never forget. Remember that.
Remember that to be the best, you have to work at it. So, you have to go through the good and the bad. Good luck in whatever road you choose to follow, and never let anyone tell you that you don't deserve it. Good luck in cheering. Even though we may not be here every day, you know that we'll still be cheering anymore.
Please Boys varsity basketball team and football team.
As stated before, I'd like to again emphasize the accomplishments of this year's Boys varsity team. First, they continued the Cougar winning tradition with an overall record of 17 wins and 4 losses. 4 of their losses coming from split, a win and loss record for the Class B teams, which again, we proved that we could beat every team as we did this season. Beginning of the season, we won the Bobcat Shootout tip-off tournament, CBAC All-Star Selection, Stephen Carter, first team, Jamie Davidson, second team, Connor Chapman, honorable mention. This year we maintain honorable mention in Class B state rankings, and again continuing a great tradition of basketball as we have been ranked every year for the last 5 years. Selected, probably one of the most important awards, selected by the officials as a sportsmanship award, is not only showing a tradition of excellence on the court, but outstanding character as well. And last but not least, our athletic talents go along with our academic talents with a great deal of selection as far as our students performing in the classrooms as well. I try to look back on 3 highlights of the season. First and foremost would not be something that took place on the basketball court. And that would be our monthly basketball mentoring buddies with the students at Rosas Point Elementary. Learning that community service is a big part of being a productive member in our local communities. Maybe they made a difference to younger athletes that wish to excel as our program does, and most importantly, they made a difference to many young people that needed a big brother. 2, an outstanding senior night performance, a great game beating Plattsburgh High School in front of a great crowd. It meant a lot for our seniors to end that last home game of the win. And I would say our 3rd highlight would be, as probably expected, our freshman Tom Bedard getting a basket bringing us to overtime as we had given Peru their only loss of the season. At this time, I would like to recognize the players in this year's squad who worked to achieve the above accomplishment. Tom Bedard, only a freshman, Tom's offseason commitment landed him valuable minutes on the varsity squad. He has a great attitude and work ethic, which is why he is able to achieve his personal goals. Tom's continued determination should allow him to be a future force for many years in the CBAC. Rob Armstrong, a sophomore, who has continued to make great progress daily in his performance. His confidence is greatly improving, which is allowing him to take the risk needed to be a productive basketball player. With a personal goal for improved shooting, Rob should be a valuable asset to next year's team. Richie Collins, a junior, who has the ability to be a presence in the post position. Richie's all-around game has improved, and with a commitment to persevere, has the ability to have a good senior year. Nathan LeFave, a junior, with a lot of heart. Nate always puts forth his best effort, which allows players around him to be motivated to give the best. He has a great attitude and is very supportive of his teammates and is a joy on our team. Logan Miller, a junior, whose dribbling abilities improved a lot by the end of the season. Again, a great student athlete who will be very successful in his senior year. Although not one of his best shooting years, the experience he has gained this year will allow him to be a great threat next year. Jamie Davidson, a junior, with an outstanding ability to get the ball off the floor. He leads the team in assists and steals. With more improvement from other guards, hopefully Jamie will have the opportunity to get more shots off next year. He's determined year after year to keep our Cougar program at the top of the long range of successful programs. Again, congratulations to Jamie on being selected as a second team CBAC All-Star. Stephen Carter, a junior, who leads the team in points, rebounds, and blocks. Stephen, selected as a solid first team CBAC All-Star, stands the highest score of the game with 35 points this year. He is committed to getting better and will have a stellar of a senior season. I recognize Stephen as this year's most valuable player. Katie Tierney, who has received the award on behalf of Mr. Davison and myself and teams. Senior manager, whose leadership skills were unmatched. From her food to her putting equipment away, or simply her words of wisdom, she'll be greatly missed. You are by far the greatest manager I have ever had, and appreciate all you have done to take the initiative to help us assist, with our program. Freddie Hatwood, a senior. A senior with heart. Often the energizer bunny, not knowing when to slow down, Freddie always puts forth his best effort. He's a hard worker and a great young man, who also has a great outside shot. He'll be greatly missed. Randy Grimshaw, a senior. A senior leader who always inspired the team with his reflective chats. Randy is one of, if not the best defenders on the team. He also, I may add, joins Freddie, and also the most likely to commit a foul as well. It was great to have Randy on the team. His enthusiasm was contagious to fellow players. Casey Miano, a senior, who as the season progressed, played more minutes. His moves may not always look the smoothest. However, he always got the job done, whether it was a needed rebound or a basket at a critical time. Casey was a critical component to the victory of several of our games. I present Casey Miano with the Most Improved Player Award. Connor Chapman, a senior, whose story should be a life lesson for younger athletes. As a freshman, Connor's last chance to be in the program, he was close to being eliminated. He then became a sophomore, playing very limited minutes and getting a basket probably every fourth game. With total commitment to becoming a better player and a response plan to my very clear directives and concerns, Connor chose to go for the stars instead of walking away. He soon became the junior and senior who was critical to the team's success. He had several games this year finishing around the 15-point mark or higher. I wish him much success as he plans on playing for Clinton next year, and I'm sure his new coach will say his name as often as I have during practice. He is a poster athlete for younger athletes who can believe anything is possible when you put your mind to it. Good luck to all of our seniors in your future endeavors. I'd like to also give special recognition to returning players of Stephen Carter, Jamie Davison, Connor Chapman, Casey Miano, Randy Grimshaw, Richie Collins, and Fred Hackett, who've combined for a 2-year record of 39 wins and 5 losses, which is clearly the most successful program over any other CBAC program. Congratulations to all of our winter sports teams. Special recognition to the girls' cheerleading squad. Your hard work and dedication do not go unnoticed. And congratulations for once again being champions and keeping your program on the top. Thank you for keeping our crowd energized at our games. Thank you for Calvin. Thank you to fellow coaches Jerry and Casey for your involvement in the program. Thank you to Tim Carter and Randy Davison for keeping the stats during the games. Thank you to Mrs. Gilroy. I am one of those coaches that you have never made mad, Mrs. Gilroy. Thank goodness for email, right, Mrs. Gilroy? Thank you to Josie and Booster Club, who have been very instrumental, especially in the purchases of our new warm-ups and our jerseys. I'm very, very concerned about the future of our Booster Club because the Carols, the Franks, and the Josies, and the Kiernans, and everybody else that Mrs. Changelo, and I can name 3 or 4 others that are very instrumental in this program. We're losing some key assets. If you don't pick that up, there's a big problem I see for the future. So we definitely need some help and support with that to get our teams going in the right direction. A special thanks to Frank Dumas, who after 7 years of coaching, we often say thank yous after awards night. For mine, it's a little more blessed because of the influence he's had on me in my younger years involving me in coaching at such a young age, and wondering why I'm still standing here today. So thank you to Coach Dumas. Thank you to my parents, the team, for being late evenings. And last but not least, thank you to my team as always. I'm very, very pleased. And as you get to griping, you always remember I am always in your corner and you remember you are kidding me. Thank you.
Laura Flowerday. Mary Lou DeFranco. Rachel Marble. Courtney Bond. Megan Coleman. Chelsea Brooks. Carrie Dominic. Katrina Gary. Jessica Ashley. Bianca Grimshaw. Justine Redwood. Paige Sutherland. 10 members of the girls varsity basketball team also qualified for the New York State Polo High School Athletic Association Scholar Athlete Team Award. Please take a step forward when I call your name. Jess Ashline, Megan Bowman, Chelsea Brooks, Carrie Dominic, Marla Flyby, Mary Elizabeth Frankie, Katrina Gearing, Bianca Grimshaw, Justine Rowley, Paige South. Congratulations.
And many of you, and I'm sure there's a lot of other volunteers come in and help out, and I really appreciate it, because that's our future, and you're doing a really, really good job. Thank you. I want to congratulate all the other Lewis sports teams. They all had a great year. I know how hard they all work, and they deserve to be recognized. And I didn't really realize this year just how many people are actually involved in our program until I started writing them all down. It's amazing. I probably forgot some of you, but if I did, I'm sorry. To all the rest of you, you have my utmost respect and gratitude. Now my team. I didn't realize you're that smart, all those honors. You can't even get a play right. No, seriously. I get four sophomores. I didn't know if I should keep all four, but I know who went. Jess Ashon, Paige Southwick, Bianca Grimshaw, and Justine Armin. Jess Ashon had the pleasure this year of doing most of our practices in the garden with Chelsea Brooks. That's not a favorite job. And it probably wasn't a lot of home for Jess, but it certainly improved her game. She had to learn how to guard Chelsea along with playing defense. And it improved her game tremendously. So her shots hit a lot better, and she's getting more experience. And I expect a lot from her next year. Paige also had a tough task of guarding Katrina. Another good job. But Paige never complained. She just went out and did the best she could. She too improved. Her defense got better, and her shot got better. I think she's getting to like her shooting a lot because she's certainly not afraid to take it. But that's okay, I like her. Bianca. Her strong point is defense. Whenever she's in the game, you can bet she's going to get a couple of steals. And she's very unselfish. She's going to give up that pass to the girl in there every time. She always cheers on her teammates and is a joy to coach. And I'll bet if you look over her right now, she's probably got a big smile on her face. There we go. Justine Radley is a competitor. That's the best word I can find for her. Whether it's in a game or practice, she plays hard. She has a fiery little spirit in her, but sometimes you have to calm down a little bit. She's very quick, is improving all the time. I believe that she's going to be a very good player in the future. All four of these girls are going to be a big part of our program in the future years. I'm very confident that they will all live up to that task. Now, I have six juniors. Megan Bogle. A lot of people don't know this, but and I didn't know until only 5-6 games a year that she injured her knee. And she had some tough practices and she never complained. Whenever I asked her, did it hurt too much to play? And she'd say, no, I'm fine, coach. And I gained respect for her toughness. She had a little playing time this year, but she never complained. She always worked hard in her practices, and I hope that she keeps working hard and good things are going to follow. Courtney Bond. Another girl that plays with a lot of emotion. Sometimes that emotion gets her into trouble, but I calm her down and we seem to get along. I was very pleased with her hard work this year. She started getting more playing time as the year went on. She plays very good defense and forced several turnovers when they're home. Her offense is also picking up nicely. I thought Kobe improved tremendously throughout the year. For that, I awarded her with the most improved player. Carrie had the best game when she gets upset. I love it when she goes to the basket hard. She seems more focused and the results are better. She helps out and rebounds for us greatly. That's not an easy job, honestly, but I thought Carrie did the job very well. I'm looking forward to a big year from her next year. Rachel Barton. She had a great year for us. She too is emotional. There are a lot of emotional players on her team. When she gets her game going right, Rachel, though, she is very hard to stop. She drives the basket very well, and her outside shooting is getting better all the time. She led our team this year in 3-pointers, and she averaged over 10 points a game. When it came time for choosing plays for the All-Star teams, she fell just a few points short. Although you did fall a few points short of Rachel, I know you are an All-Star, and next year you're going to get one. Chelsea Brooks. I couldn't really find a good word for her, but I think there's a lot of words to describe her. She's just a team player, and that's purely, that's what she wants to do. She doesn't care how many points she gets, or rebounds, steals, assists, three-pointers, or even her turnovers. She doesn't care. All she cares about is that score and the clock. This girl is not only needs our shooting and games, she does it during practice, and she does it very well. She is also very well liked by her teammates, and she's certainly led by example. There are several coaches in this league that would love to have her on their team, but they can't have her. I've got her. She did receive recognition from all the other area coaches, though, as she was selected to the first team CBAC All-Star, a great accomplishment. She also received recognition from her own coach, as I selected her as my most valuable player. Katrina Guerin, she was born to play basketball. That's what they did. They just made her a baby and she can't play basketball. She excels in all aspects of her game. She ran into a little trouble though, down in Austin, Colorado. She got caught up in another girl and bent her thumb back, so I had to learn how to keep the thumb. That slowed me down a little bit, but she still played hard. Then the big ball for her was in our fifth or sixth game in Peru. In the season in Peru, she got caught up with another player and hurt her shoulder. She was not the same player the rest of the season. Before the injury, though, she was averaging over 20 points a game. After the injury, she still averaged over 16 points a game. Even with a bad right shoulder, she was still a dominant player in our league. I was truly impressed with Katrina for playing through all the pain. The rest of the league was also impressed as they chose Katrina as the MVP in the CBAC. A great accomplishment. I have also chosen her as our most valuable player. And now my two seniors. The first one's not here, but Mara had some bad luck this year. She had a lot of injuries and some illnesses caused her to miss a lot of time. And she must have one game tonight. But when she did play them, she showed how good a player she was. She could really get the job done. And I'm going to miss Mara. She had all the troubles we had to get her mind sometimes, but she is a really good girl. I have closer to all levels of our basketball program, and we've had a lot of good memories. I wish her much success in her future endeavors. Mary Elizabeth Frankie. Everyone should coach Mary Elizabeth. She had a bad ankle this year, and I had to take it every night, practice, games, and we had some very educational talks during 23 minutes. Such topics as the color of the painted toenails on certain days, make sure you shave your legs on game day, and wear your socks all day to make your feet smell. I thought I didn't know. Hard to believe though, Mary had injuries this year. But to my amazement, she played hard through them all. She's a very hard worker for us every night. I love the way she played. I want to congratulate her also on being selected to the third team All-Star in the CBAC. A very nice accomplishment. But I think she will always be remembered when she stole the ball and went on the court, and she had that famous gazelle strut, whatever she calls it, where she takes about 10 feet for each of the last two steps. Lays the ball in the basket. I'm certainly going to miss you, Mary Elizabeth. Good luck in everything you decide to do. When you come back and watch us play next year, if you get away from us, sneak over here. Okay. Now just for a quick recap of our team. I didn't realize this, but last year's team went 18-2 in regular season. They won the sectionals and made it to the Final Four. They lost to the eventual champion in Class B. From that team, we lost the head coach, the assistant head coach, 8 of the players, 4 of them were starters, and we had a very good job ahead of us. We started strong with 6 wins in a row, including wins on Malone, Messina, and Saranac, all 4 teams. And then dropped that very nice Peru. We not only lost the game, but we lost our top scorer for the next couple weeks. We were not the same team for the rest of the year. Every time we start to play well again, someone else will get hurt or sick. We did good our next 7 games, but I don't think we played as well as we could. We struggled to beat teams that we beat by 25 points the first time. Well, our struggles finally caught up with us in Lake Placid. They have a pretty good team up in Lake Placid, but my girls will agree with me, we should have won that game. Now we have Saranac and Poole in the same week. These two games were the most intense games I've ever coached in my life. I had several people ask me this year if I felt any pressure coaching at Northeastern. I honestly didn't feel it at first. Well, during this week, I think I learned the word, or meaning of the word, pressure. We prevailed both those games, and I couldn't wait for Friday to come. We ended up tied with Saranac in the best record lead at 14-2. Since we beat Saranac 2 times, we were awarded first place in Division 1 of the CPAC. Playoffs are now here, and we have a tough game with Los Angeles, but we can get out and win. Well, here we go with the Saranac girls again. They say that it's hard to beat a team 3 times in the same year. Well, they were right. We picked the worst game of the year to have an off night. I don't really come to expect championships here at Northeastern. We came up just a little bit short this year. But in no way do I consider this team a failure. I'm very proud of those 12 girls over there. I'm very glad to have been the coach. I'm sad to say goodbye to Mary and Mara. I wish both of you my best wishes. To those of you, keep working hard. Next year, we're going to come back and we're going to finish the job. Thank you, girls, for a wonderful season.
I'd just like to say thank you to our parents, family, friends, and our loyal fans for all their support and encouragement throughout this past season. We'd like to also thank our favorite cameraman, Calvin Cassidy, for taking our names. We would have not as been as successful as we were without our team's bonding spirit and energy. Although we lost to Peru and Lake Placid, we battled hard for our first place spot in CPAC. We deserved every point and did our best to make it to the top. To my fellow teams, you girls are the greatest. I love each and every one of you and consider you all part of my family. To Mary and Mara, you will be missed tremendously and better come back next year to watch us pick some up.
Our road to success has come with lots of laughter and some tears. We have known to be quite complex there. From Ranch slipping and falling on a warm-up dance as she tried to get that land. The coach missing my pass. Falling forward as he tripped over his own feet. We also think the yard is completely inside. Katrina singing karaoke at the office while she's smoking her marionette, but our dancing technique to make it a spot dancing star. On a much more serious note, thank you, Coach Leonard. The wisdom, confidence, and power you have shown for leading our team has been inspiration on and off the court. The skills and lessons you have taught us will be used for our lifetimes. I came across this poem and thought it sums up our season well. I finally learned what life is all about. The secret of success comes hard and fast. I drank, I sweat, I ate. I cried, I tried out, I got every time I tried. I was pushed at, yelled at, preached at too. But the more this happened, the more I grew. You can be anything you want to be, this voice could try at me. Yet, who can I blame such a daring approach? That journey.